Democrats introducing articles of impeachment.
Indictment of the president.
We're introducing articles of impeachment to remove President Trump from office.
Oh, they're just going to impeach him? This is their only option?
Now that Democrats have control of the House, you might be wondering what they're going to do with it. Well, they've been telling us all along. I'm Anders Hagstrom, and these are the facts. Now that the Democrats have control of the House, we can expect two things. One, a lot more subpoenas in the Russia investigation, and the impeachment of President Donald Trump. Now, to be clear, there's no chance he'll get removed from office. For that, you need a supermajority in the Senate, but all you need in the House to approve impeachment is a simple majority. Democrats have been clamoring to impeach the president since basically the day he was elected.
Impeach 45!
Impeachment.
Impeach.
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 Impeachment investigation.
It's impeached!
They've put forward actual articles of impeachment multiple times, and their base expects them to go through with it now that they actually have some power. Now, Nancy Pelosi has said she doesn't have stomach for impeachment, but she's the least popular politician in America. Can anyone really count on her to keep the Democrat base in check? And then there are the subpoenas. Make no mistake, the next 2 years of Trump's presidency are going to be brutal. The Democrats aren't messing around, and they'll use everything in their power to make Trump look bad and get him out of office. They'll be starting new investigations, hampering administrative agencies, you name it. But remember how much Republicans surged during the Kavanaugh hearings? Maybe 2 years of partisan, anti-Trump political investigations is just what Trump needs to galvanize Republicans and win in 2020. And now let's go to some of your comments. Bob Cornell says, all conservatives will, the letter B, servants. We will be, are we going to be turned into slaves? Or servants, will we be paid? We'll just be butlers? Like, I mean, I'd be down for that. Steady paycheck, you just sweep the floors. I don't know. Antoinette Novello says, this guy is an idiot. Questiony face, and then she says, Q is very real. As in QAnon, which I think speaks for itself, you know? There's no level of foolishness that reaches the belief in QAnon. I'm gonna keep digging this hole, dude, because anyone who believes in QAnon is not paying attention. Greta Hansen commenting on our video about the Democrats possibly running Michael Avenatti or Hillary Clinton in 2020, she says, sweet Jesus, either candidate would be like manna from heaven for conservatives. It's so true. It's so true. I can't think of any two candidates running against each other that would be more beneficial for Donald Trump in 2020. Like, can you imagine? Though, should elections be, like, entertaining? That's a sort of different question. I don't know. Maybe they shouldn't. Maybe they should go back to being boring, like in 2008. Jack Strelick says, you are a moron. He messaged that. He didn't comment on one of his videos. He took the time to, like, click on my little profile thing. Oh, Anders M. Hagstrom. Like me on Facebook. Or call me a moron, whichever one. He took the time and clicked it and then like typed out this message. He's like, you're a moron. And he doesn't even have a Facebook profile picture. I don't even know what he looks like. I cannot see the face of my accuser. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and share this video if you liked it and want to share it. And be sure to like our page at the DCNF Presents the Facts and our friends over at American Voices and the Daily Caller. And if you're watching on Facebook, you can like my page in the description. Thanks for watching.